In this video, we want to show some simple questions that CPhrase can answer. So we have a very simple database. We have our customers. We have our items. And then we have the transactions where customers are buying those items. Now, if we come up here, we'll see some examples. So let's look at this customer that bought apples. So the customers that bought apples, here they are. And if we notice here, we can see the SQL associated with the interpretation. And if we go up here, we can get another example here. So we can say the customers that bought apples and bananas. All right, so in this case here, these are the customers that bought either apples or bananas. If we want to actually have the true and, then we can say bought apples and bought bananas. And if we look at this SQL, then it's got a bit more complicated joins. So if we look at the examples here, we can continue here. Those customers that did not buy apples, and that would be Dave. And the customers, the names of the customers that bought every item. So that's Alice. Alice bought every item. And then if we look, we say the names of the customers that didn't buy every item. That's the rest of the customers, Bob, Charlie, and Dave. And then we can make this a bit more specific by saying the customers that bought every type of fruit. And in that case, we let Bob in as well. Okay, so let's look just at this is the kind of the SQL that gets generated from this question up here. So if we continue on here, then basically let's look at this one right here. We look at the customers with at least three transactions with date after 60 days ago. All right, and only Alice and Bob qualify there. If we look at the actual, we want to see the actual transactions of them. Now there's an ambiguity here. We want to attach the transactions to the we want to attach the date here to the to when they did the three transactions. So this is what we get here. So we get these are all the transactions, but we do want the three latest. So let's basically say the three latest of those transactions. And what we'll notice here is we'll notice that that is going to just be Alice, just Alice's. And note here these all sum to 35, but let's see what would happen if we basically say sum amount here. Let's verify that we get that right. So then we come here, and indeed it is 35. One final example I just want to show here is a question like this. Like the customers with transactions of apples or bananas, so they bought apples or bananas, totaling over $20 within the last 60 days. Okay, looks like only Alice makes it here. Let's see if we can bring anybody else in here. We'll just do it at 10, and we'll see that, yes, indeed, we get more people coming on this one. You look at the SQL there for that query. All right, so the last thing I want to show here is just the configuration that went into to building up this example. And it's pretty simple. There's the actual database state, but here is the three tables. And we just have some word attachments here, some lexical attachments, and some CPhrase specific properties. In a future video, we'll show actually how we built this up from scratch. So that should be instructive. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.